Module 2.16, plant succession and bus factor. So in this module, I want to look at when we think about anti-fragility, how does it impact or how can you reflect on the structure and composition of your team? So if you're familiar with the concept of a bus factor, so with a bus factor, it's basically when you look at your team and you ask yourself, so if tomorrow someone from my team or even myself are hit by a bus, of course it's not something that we wish, but it's more on an intellectual level. If something happens to one of the team members, what will happen in our capacity of production, in going on, or even just, you know, existing still as an organization? So with this funny drawing here, it illustrates like, indeed, if you have one developer in your team and with a bus factor, this developer is gone, then what happens to your development? So I want to share here examples of structure of teams and maybe some points for you to reflect on when you build your team and you scale and grow your team. So of course, when you begin a team, it starts with you, you know, so you're alone and you try to cover as many positions as possible. So here I give an example of, for example, in my case, I don't code. So that's what I would cover. If I start a team from myself, I can do a bit of design, product management, but I cannot draw and I cannot code. So I would probably surround myself by a team and experts in different crafts. So somebody who can draw, somebody who can code, and somebody who's actually more dedicated and expert on design. Because I wouldn't dare to say that I can design a game fully from scratch or a system and an economy. But I can come up with concepts and high-level concepts. But here in this example, let's say with a bus factor, you have the artist gone. Well, I guess you can go on because these days, you know, in development, you can use Unity assets, for example, and buy a lot of art assets ready to continue development. So maybe you're fine. But then, now the designer is gone. What happens to your team? And in this case, I would even argue that maybe you'll be fine because either you as the team lead or the developer can cover the design role and you can still prototype or develop something. But you are not in a great shape to create something big or create something that will maybe go until the next milestone as you get your funding or your approval validation to continue. So in other scenarios, however, when you think of a bus factor, what happens if your only developer is gone? Or if you as a team lead are gone? That means that maybe you don't want to continue, something happened to you, you're really sick. Well, unfortunately, in these two cases, the whole team disperses. There's no point in continuing because either you cannot continue or develop any games, or the leader of the team who has the vision, the direction basically for the team is gone. So what is left? So think about it, how fragile is your team based on the bus factor, and if some key person have to leave tomorrow, what will happen to the whole structure and foundation of your organization? And here, let's go a bit further in the example of a robust team. So starting with the same base here, there's yourself and one person per craft. What you can do to make the team more robust is to add an additional person for each craft to make sure that there's always someone to back up the work of the other, or in case someone is sick, someone is gone, you know, that person can always cover for the other. So I like that system when you think in pairs. Basically, if you are gone tomorrow, if you're going on holiday, you're sick, you're not feeling well, you know, all the events of life, can your studio continue to run? Do you have people to cover for your work? And make sure that you always have. It could be different person or it could be the same person covering for different roles. So it's even better if you have multi-skills people in your team. And that's what I would advise, especially at early stage. And at last, I wanted to share more some thoughts here about really How can you think of growing your organization in a more interfragile way as you scale and as you have a solid base? In the end, it's not about scaling and having thousands of people to cover the work of each other, but it's about growing people to become leaders. So one area is really think of how you can develop your people to also become leaders. And not just you having the vision, having the direction. Who else in the team can navigate the ship with you? And second, it's really important, and I don't think we talk often about it, but like I said, anything can happen. And you know, these days with COVID, actually we know that a lot of things can happen that we cannot foresee in the next weeks or month. So it's really important to design also a succession plan. Who will cover or take the work from you if you had to stop today, or if you had to go on different ventures, be promoted? That's a very common thing to do when you develop people, or thinking also of a succession plan. And so for our studio, how does it look like? So here, that's our current organization, and we are 14 people. And the way I have crafted the team and design or structure is this way. So if tomorrow I'm gone because I don't know, something happened, or I'm very sick, or I'm not feeling well, or I go on holiday for a month, who knows, who can cover for me? And this is important for me, that the studio continues to run also without me for a temporary time. So I have a co-lead that I named and promoted over the past year to train to be able to run the organization as I do. And I groom the person to this position, and still groom the person today to this position. Same happened for other crafts. Here, for example, in art or tech, if tomorrow the art leads or tech leads, for some reasons, have to leave, cannot continue to work, they already have prepared, groomed people in their team to take the position, the leadership, if something happens, or one day when they get promotion. And same goes as well for designers. So think about really in your organization, how you grow different leaders, so you are not the only leader in this organization. And second, do you have a clear succession plan in the scenario that you or different key people will have to leave, and how long it will take for you to recover from this? If you can recover in a few days, in a week, it's a good sign, you are quite ready for a different scenario. If it takes 3 to 6 months to replace a person and continue the operation, you are in a setup where you are more fragile, actually. So think about it.